Thank you, Mr. President. I rise today to honor a significant historical event to Western New York, to Irish Americans, to the United States, Canada, and Ireland, the Fenian Invasion of 1866 that took place on June 1st, 1866, to this week we celebrate its 150th anniversary. Just last week, I welcomed to Buffalo the Lord Mayor of Dublin, Creagh na Dalí, who came to our city to help kick off the entire week of activities honoring this significant event. This weekend, the Consul General of Ireland, Barbara Jones, will be in town to celebrate the occasion with us. The Black Rock Historical Society, the Ancient Order of Hibernians, and many different Irish heritage organizations have come together to put on a magnificent celebration in honor of this historical occasion. A brief history of the Fenian invasion of 1866 will help illustrate the extreme significance of this anniversary and why such an event is important to the people of this state and this country. As I mentioned, on June 1st, 1866, about 500 to 800 Irish nationalists and United States Civil War veterans known as Fenians embarked from the docks of the Pratt Iron Works in Buffalo to invade Canada, seize it, and barter it for Irish freedom from British rule. The Fenian Brotherhood had been founded in 1858 in the United States and found its roots in the Irish United Irishmen and other Irish nationalist groups. The Fenian forces, again mainly Civil War veterans that served this country bravely and proudly, arrived in Buffalo at the Exchange Street train station. They gathered in the old First Ward, the old Irish neighborhood, and launched their attack from the Pratt Iron Works, now known as Towpath Park. The Fenians defeated the Crown forces across the Niagara River at the Battle of Ridgeway, outnumbered and outgunned, and briefly held Fort Erie, but they suffered a setback when President Andrew Johnson blocked the reinforcements and sent Generals Grant and Meade to quell this invasion. Now, these Civil War veterans, still dedicated to their commander-in-chief, followed his orders, came back onto U.S. soil, and all were pardoned, although some had lost their lives. The Fenian invasion demonstrated that independence and democracy are forces that no amount of oppression can prevent. Even outnumbered and outgunned, the Fenians valiantly battled the British Crown forces in Canada. Despite this, the Fenian invasion had a profound and lasting impact on the two British colonies, Canada and Ireland. The momentum for independence grew in Canada and was achieved 1 year and 1 month to the date, on July 1st, 1867, still to this day celebrated as Canadian Independence Day. Each year, Canada celebrates the Fenian raid. And given its supremely vital importance into the incorporation of Canada as a nation, this event is recognized across the globe. In Ireland, 50 years later, this also gave great momentum to the uprising on Easter Monday in 1916. To this year, we celebrate its centennial. In recognition of the significant event of the Fenian invasion of Canada, Buffalo now has a monument in Towpath Park where this invasion set off from, on the banks of the Niagara River, dedicated to this moment in history, honoring those brave men and women who participated in this significant event for Irish independence. I want to recognize my colleagues of all ethnicities, especially my colleagues of Irish American descent on both sides of the aisle, for helping to bring this important resolution to the floor today. I want to thank everyone in the chamber for taking the time to recognize this important date in our country's history, the history of Canada, the history of Ireland, and I ask everyone to keep in mind the contributions these Civil War soldiers gave to the United States.
Some order in the House, please. Thank you, Senator Kennedy.
I'd like to ask everyone to keep in mind the bravery and dedication that these United States Civil War soldiers gave to our country, to Canada, and to Ireland. Thank you, Mr. President.